Trying to spray it, and it wouldn't. Instead of spraying, it would like give you this tiny squirt. It was like almost like someone urinating.
I don't know why it goes back to the urination all the time. Okay, got it.
There's different types of alcohols.
Yeah, yeah.
Like there's benzyl alcohol. There's there's a natural whatever they use, you know, for like ethyl alcohol, which is what I use, right?
It's
just to make a perfume. But these compounding houses, they have so many types of alcohols that they can put, you know, in certain ratios to correspond to whatever else is in there, so that it can potentiate it to the max.
I see.
And they, you know, these are all chemists.
Yeah, so
they know how to do all that.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm actually, you mentioned something about me always going back to urination, which is something that interests me, because today, what I wanted to show you.
Okay.
Yesterday we talked about urine.
Yeah, right? Yes, we did.
Today I want to talk about feces.
Oh, okay.
If that's okay with you.
Well, yeah, if you're keeping it the same, yeah, it seems like.
As long as it's not like proper, like.
Yeah, well, it seems like we're you know.
No, I'm
since
going.
Since we're talking about.
I'm going to hand you a proper piece of actual excrement.
Okay.
Do you mind?
No.
Let's try.
I mean, is there anything more natural? Than, no? I mean, yeah.
This is. A piece of feces.
Okay.
You can smell it.
Whose feces is it exactly?
Moby Dick.
Okay.
I'm not kidding.
No, I'm sure you're not kidding.
This is the feces.
I'm sure you're not kidding, because it does have a little smell of the feces.
And I'm not kidding about Moby Dick either. This is the feces of the sperm whale.
Oh, okay.
100%.
Oh. Okay. Wow.
How does that feel, just holding that?
I feel privileged, actually.
You feel it's a privilege?
Oh, it's a privilege.
I'm holding a piece of whale.
Yeah, you know, it only could have been better to hold the sperm of the sperm. I'll just have to, you know, use this. But, yeah.
That's funny. That's funny. That's something. Yeah, this is actual whale poo.
Okay.
Yeah, it's ambergris. Yeah.
Okay.
It's the second most expensive animal ingredient in perfumery. The first being the musk, which we tried yesterday.
Okay.
This is the most legendary fixative, apart from deer musk, in all of perfumery. In Yemen, they actually eat this for sexuality. They say that it boosts.
It's an aphrodisiac.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's whale, you know, done, you know, it's like, some people have the theory that it is whale vomit.
Okay.
Right? And it can be that.
Okay.
It can be a regurgitation.
How actually, since we're on the, you know, talking about this.
Yeah.
How does someone actually, you know, obtain this from a sperm whale?
It just floats to the beach.
Okay.
It's like beach combed ambergris.
Well, how do they know it's not from someone else or something else?
It's been studied for centuries.
Okay.
And it's like when they used to hunt the whales,
yeah,
you know, when they used to make soap with blubber and so forth.
Yeah.
They used to also take the ambergris
from
inside the intestinal tract.
Okay.
Which is why it has been banned. It still is banned in Australia and the US. Ambergris is banned.
Oh,
right.
Okay.
Because of the you know, like for protecting the whale. No one is going to hunt a sperm whale in order to get the ambergris.
No, of course
it's
not.
Like no one does that anymore.
Yeah.
You just walk along the beach and then you see a pile of fragrant smelling dung, and then that's your fortune. You just hit the jackpot. I mean, it's like people have made fortunes just by walking along the beaches. I mean, just for this purpose.
Really?
Yeah, looking for ambergris.
Yeah, I mean, Allah works in mysterious ways.
Yeah.
everyone has their risks, subhanAllah.
Yeah, subhanAllah.
So, so if you don't mind me asking, so you just keep this on your dinner table, or what do you use this for?
I would normally pound it to smaller pieces. Okay. This is another harvest.
So this is pounded.
This is broken
sperm whale.
Yeah, pounded sperm whale feces.
Okay.
Yeah, this is broken chips from it. You can smell it.
Okay. Oh yeah, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah.
It does have that sort of like sea smell to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's wonderful. I mean, yeah. the iodine and the sea salt,
yeah, yeah.
And the effects of the sun, yeah. You know, as it floats until it reaches the shore. Yeah, it's quite fascinating.
Smells like it, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah.
How much would you pay for something like this?
Well, I have to admit, you know, I don't think I'd really pay a lot for feces. I mean, unless I knew that I could. I mean, you know, you hear about all these things, you know, like rhino horn and all this stuff. You know, the people spend a lot of money on because
yep.
It's an aphrodisiac or it's some kind of health benefit or whatever. But you know, these things, because I don't think this is different, obviously, because you're not hurting the whale taking the feces,
right?
Unless you hunt it for that reason. But if you find it on a beach, I think it's.
It's harmless,
and if people find benefit in that. But if they're going to sell it to someone like me, and they're going to say, I want $1,000 for some sperm whale feces, I think I'd probably turn that down. most likely I would turn that down.
You wouldn't go for it?
No, not really. I mean, you know, I paid $1,000 for a lot of stuff, uh-huh. But none of it was feces. I mean, you're probably going to tell me this is probably worth a lot more.
It's worth a lot more than
$1,000. Yeah, yeah. I kind of figured that since it was sitting on your table right here in front of you, because I didn't think it would be, I figured it had some value to it if you had it here. So, so what's the story?
Well, I mean, you know, the premium grades, they go for like 30 to 40,000 euros a kilo.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and you can get it for 20,000. 25,000 for the, you know, average grades.
Okay. Is it specific? I mean, no other, pardon my, but no other whale feces would be as good as this?
No, other whale feces is ambergris.
Okay.
Only sperm whale feces is ambergris, for the record, because someone came to me again and they said, we were studying this thing on the internet and we read this website and the guy says he's a perfumer for the royal families all over the world for 300 years.
Okay.
And he contradicts a lot of things that you say. Mm. And his ambergris picture is a humpback whale.
Okay.
So that I said, well, I don't have to look at what he says. I mean, just look at the picture. I mean, it's not even a sperm whale, so that he doesn't even know what ambergris
in the whales.
He doesn't know where ambergris comes from.
Yeah.
So how is he going to contradict anything? I mean, tell him to change the picture.
Yeah, that would kind of give it away.
Yeah.
But I guess this must be from the different types of food, I guess.
Yeah, it's actually squid, and the beaks of the squid, they irritate the digestive tract.
Okay.
And actually, we pull quite a few squid beaks out of the ambergris as we're pounding it and grinding it into powder.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, as we do. I had a collection of them. Mm. Like just this cup full of squid beaks that was from taken out of the ambergris. What I made with it, with the ambergris, not the squid beaks, is I made this tincture. And the reason I show you this is because this is the carrier for the perfume that I put on you before.
Oh.
Right. EO number one, this is the pure parfum version.
Oh, okay.
Right? Instead of plain alcohol.
I like it better now, actually.
Well, when you know that it's 40,000 kilos, I mean, it's like it changes your path.
No, I didn't say I like the feces better. I said I like the perfume better.
Yeah. I mean, normal perfume, like any perfume, this, anything, right, is diluted in just plain perfumer's alcohol.
Yeah.
Ethanol. Ethyl alcohol. Right? An ambergris tincture is normally just a component in the compound, the perfume, like the oil, which is the, you know, the perfume itself before it's cut, you know, before it's blended into ethanol. What I did with the EO number one is I took this is 10.75% tincture. This is the second steeping. All of it is gone now. It's gone into eon number one, so I have to put more alcohol to re-steep this again.
Okay.
And you can see it just re-steeps and becomes gray all over again. So you can steep it a few times.
Mm-hmm. And you'll have the same result when you do that? The same?
Roughly speaking. All right. Roughly speaking. I mean, feces is very strong, so it's like
especially sperm.
you don't lose the aromatic compound so easily. I mean, you know, by the time that is like exhausted, I mean, it'll probably probably be a long time. But I won't re-steep it too many times.
Mm-hmm.
I'll steep it like 3 times, and then in the last time, maybe a 4th time, I will include the entire actual physical ambergris in the compound. So I'll just throw that, and people can get that in the bottles.
Mm.
I don't know if it'll clog up their atomizers like a gold leaf, but I guess it'll be a collectible by that time.
Yeah.
So that's that. Now I have the equivalent, this is another tincture, this is also alcohol. I have the equivalent of what I showed you yesterday with the deer musk. You remember the musk and sandalwood?
Yes, I remember that, yeah.
So this is ambergris,
okay,
in exactly the same sandalwood
as
the musk. This is the Mysore from 1984, and I give you a swipe of that. Notice how he pulls out a clean arm for this one. when he applies the dish soap, on the other hand, this is unaffected.
gotta take the perks when I can.
Yeah. It's the same sandalwood as the musk one. Mysore 1984.
Mm.
How do you compare it?
Well, I say it's similar, but the musk does have a more distinct smell to it for me.
It's stronger, more palpable.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. This one.
More subtle.
Right. Nice though too. But I happen to be the musk was very nice. But this is nice.
To me, this has like an iris note. Like a soft.
Yeah.
Almost like a violet. If you can pick up like this very soft, like a purple flower smell.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah, I think I agree with you on that. But it smells, like I said, it's more subtle than the musk.
Of course.
The musk was,
ambergris is not supposed to be smelled. I mean, it's like, it's just what it does to other ingredients that you blend with it.
Yeah.
That's what ambergris is used for.
Yeah.
This is a very subtle smell. I mean, if you smell it,
yeah,
you need to really sniff in order to get the aroma from it.
Well, that's why it's hard to believe that's feces, actually.
Yeah.
Depending on what you eat, I guess.
Now you can tell how the sandalwood, which in itself is like a translucent, clear, golden liquid, is totally black.
Yeah.
In the case of the ambergris. With the musk, it was like this dark red, but still you can see through it.
Yeah.
Here it's like completely opaque, you can't see anything.
And that's the effect of the ambergris.
Which you can see here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can see that, how it's like trickling out on the side.
Yeah. And what's the percentages of
the dilution?
Yeah, dilution.
This is at 10%.
10%. Yeah. Okay.
10%.
And is that something in standard or something that you created?
I think 10% is unheard of.
Unheard.
10% is unheard of. I'm like what I've I mean, most people, from what I'm aware, they do 2%, 5% would be very high.
Mm.
And one bottle of this at 5%, there's a friend of mine who makes it. His name is Sultan. He sells it in London.
Mm.
You know how much it goes for? Like just a 50 ml bottle, 30 ml bottle of just like 5% ambergris tincture in alcohol, only this, without the sandalwood.
Yeah.
It's about, I think, 300, 400 pounds for a bottle at 5%.
Mm.
So you do the math, you got 50 ml. 10% is 5%, 5% is 2.5 grams of ambergris.
Mm.
with some alcohol goes for $300. It's a very expensive aromatic. Mm. Very expensive.
Wow.
So imagine using the tincture as the complete carrier of the, include, not counting the oud and the rose and everything else that I put in there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, I think no one did this in perfumery before. Mm. Maybe they did, but I'm just not aware of it.
Yeah. But it's nice. It's a nice mixture, actually.
Yeah. You like the smell now?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. Yeah. You mean the EO
number one?
Yeah. I like it. Yeah, I like it. Mm. It stays. It's nice.
You're not smelling the Chanel, right?
The Chanel. No. The Chanel's over here. And yeah. It was very little. And that's right here.
Right.
No. I mean, there's a clear difference. Yeah, there's a clear difference. It's nice. Yeah, that's a nice smell. Yeah. It's great to be here trying out all these...
Sheikh Ehab. Perfect. Hippie from the 1970s. like what do you call this? People go on these bike expeditions, like adventurer.
Adventurer, yeah.
Roadster.
Roadster.
Roadster, yeah. Bike.
Hitchhike. Bicycle. Yeah, this is right.
From London to Cairo on a bicycle in the 70s.
No, actually, it was in the 80s.
In the 80s?
Yeah, it was actually 1989.
1989?
No.
Wow, so not too long ago.
1989. Well, it's 20 years ago.
Right.
30 years ago.
30 years ago.
Almost 30 years ago.
Wow, so you were like 35 at that time.
I was 34, actually.
34.
Yeah.
Wow, that's insane.
Yeah. But I was in pretty good shape, though. It was nice. It was a good experience. Yeah.
MashaAllah.
Yeah. It's good. Learn, you learn as you go along.
Yeah.
And...
Did you think about perfume at all in those days?
Quite honestly, no.
Never?
No, I never really thought about it. I think when I got to Egypt, mm-hmm. The mystique of the Orient, right? You know, you always hear about the Middle East and Egypt and that. So I kind of was thinking of on the lines of incense,
uh-huh.
right? More than I was of...
the word perfume, yes. If you look at the Latin,
yeah.
Perfumum, it means through smoke.
It does.
So it's actually to perfume something with the smoke of incense.
Oh.
That's the original meaning of the word.
Subhanallah. I didn't know that. But so I was thinking, because wherever you would walk, you'd always smell, because there are a lot of perfumers and a lot of, mm-hmm. of these places, and you go into Cairo and you go into, especially Khana Khalili,
right,
the silk there, and you walk around, they're all over the place, and they have your smoke clothes place, and you feel like, wow, this is, especially when you first go there, and you're used to walking in New York City where you smell some other stuff. Right? So it's kind of nice and exciting to be there, mm-hmm. And so I think that piqued my interest in all of the, the fragrance.